2023, September 15th, 80 degrees, 79 degrees, I don't know. It's warm, warmer than it said it was going to be, but that's okay. We're going to try it anyway. Probably going to sweat a tad. What's worse than that is the wind is very unpredictable today. It basically does like 360 degrees from the time we get out there to the time it's supposed to be game time. So we think we know what we're going to do. We have somewhat of a plan. We do have a backup plan, maybe two backup plans. But we're going to try plan one first. And we're here-ish early enough. So we should be okay on time if we do decide to mix it up. Just really hope that the wind cooperates. It's very light wind, so that's what has us worried that it's just going to swirl. Mostly going to do an observation sit tonight over a bean field. We will shoot a doe if it comes in range. But yeah, mostly just observation sit. We only have one buck on camera so far that I would deem a shooter, at least that I would shoot. I think he's a five-year-old. He's definitely at least four. I think he might be five. It's a buck they named Hombre. And he's just a big hombre. Big old body buck. He doesn't have a huge rack, but just a heck of a body on him. Mature deer. Big old mature buck. So, yeah. We're going to see how it goes. Yeah, I will not say we will see what happens, but I will say we'll see how it goes.
I like that.
That's a lot better.
I like that.
So, anyway. Yeah. That's about all I know. So, we'll get back with you soon. All right, so we made it out here. We're sticking with plan A for now. The wind is definitely doing what we think. It doesn't hardly move anywhere when it's not gusting, and then when it does, it blows kind of from the north or from the northwest, which is not ideal. But as we get closer to time, it's going to be a better wind. The exact opposite would happen if we went to the other spot. It'd be good getting in, bad for when the deer would start moving. So we're just picking one, rolling the dice. Unless it just screams terrible when we get down there, we'll probably hunt there. If not, then we may back up and try something else. But for now, we're going to go check it out. And beans have really yellowed since we got here last week, so that's kind of a bummer. Hopefully down there, they're a little bit greener. They were last week, so we'll get down there, get set up, do a hanging hunt. This will take a little bit of time, and hopefully see some. Say the least. A 20 minute deal turned into like an hour and 20 minutes, so, but it's still pretty early. The first one of the year is always the toughest, and we also picked like the crookedest tree in the forest. But it's almost 5 o'clock, we still got 2.5 hours, and one of our cameras, there's a couple deer that just popped up not too awful far from here, so they may make their way here. Sam will show you in a minute, but this bean field is pretty dried up and turning yellow and brown, except for this one little patch right here, which is why we sat up here. It's the greenest here as it is anywhere that we can see. So hopefully the deer work into this green patch will give us a pretty close shot. There is a lot of brush and leaves and branches and stuff, but there's still some shooting lanes. We did kick up one deer coming in, but as far as we know, that's the only one we saw. It was like a doe, so. Since we made so much noise and racket, we're going to try to stay quiet for the remainder of the evening, and hopefully something comes out in this field. And Sam's got his bow too, just in case, so let's kill him. smoke.
Good job, dude. Good job, bro.
Right there.
What a way to. Hold on, I gotta go this way. What a way to.
Dude, right there.
Dude, that's awesome.
33 yards.
Dude. Oh, man.
Punched. Heart shot, I'm pretty sure.
The way she flipped, I got her flipped. Dude, that's awesome. Are you shaking? I'm shaking. Dude, what time is it? I don't even know what time it is.
6:11. We still got an hour and a half.
Dude, I might have to shoot mine. I don't think Jim Deere made that noise, dude. That's crazy, bro.
Yeah.
They're blowing a little bit.
Dude, she's down.
What a my hands are sweating, dude. I was so scared. Oh my god. What an opening day. Oh, they're sitting over. Oh, let's see if I can get her over here. I got the low one. What a day, dude.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Now I'm getting the shakes.
Dude, I
opening day. As crazy as like the broadhead situation that I had.
I know.
2 days before season, I had to completely sight everything back in for a different broadhead because the broadheads that I had were just sporadic. I couldn't get a pin on anything. So got these other broadheads and it worked.
That's crazy.
And as I told him, I was like, I'm not sure I'm even comfortable at 30 yards, to be honest with you. Like, I am. I wouldn't be out here if I wasn't. But, like, I knew it was going to have to be in an open field like this.
Yeah.
And it was like 33, 34 yards.
Dude, that's still crazy, though, man. Like,
I'm pretty sure it was a heart check.
I mean, it looked good. She kicked good.
Yeah, she.
I mean, I think it was. I mean, obviously, she's down, so.
She's down, yeah. The other does are like, what is going on?
Yeah.
And then that one moved past it, but moved further out, so it was like 34, 35 yards, 30, yeah, somewhere in there.
And that's that mature doe.
And I knew my 30 pin was shooting just a smidge high right at 30, so I knew I didn't have to, you know, adjust much. And I aimed low, and it hit low. And, it hit right where I was aiming. Right, I was aiming at the heart, and I'm pretty sure I just smoked your heart.
So. Hang and hunt, September 15th.
It was a joy to get in here, man.
Dude, we're rusty. We are rusty.
Yeah. But I was like, you know what? If a good doe comes in, I'm going to shoot it.
Yeah.
And the other doe is a good doe, too.
I know.
I think there's a 2 or 3 year old doe, a 2 year old doe, and a 1 year old doe all together. I don't know why they didn't have babies, but they were all mature does, or, you know, adults.
Yeah. Dude, I'm still shaking. Like, I'm pumped for you, dude. That's awesome.
Now it's Sam's turn. Now I'm going to get in the camera and see what happens. Thank you, God.
Oh my gosh. Dude, that's so cool. You can't ask for anything better than that.
Opening day. That's a first.
Dude. I just can't stop that. Dude, okay, so that little limb, like right there, I had to let my bow down because. because I'm like, oh crap, I can't even get a hold of her, and I'm like shaking so bad because I'm so excited. And I thought that was a pretty good shot.
Yeah.
I think I looked good, felt good. So, dude, man, that's awesome, dude. I'm so pumped. You know, honestly, like, I honestly was just wanting to film. I really was. Like, I was wanting to film. Corey can take a shot, whatever. But, I don't know. Dude, this is so surreal. Like, just coming out here with a buddy and just hunting the lease property and just doing this and having fun, man. This is what it's all about. So,
doing a little bit of doe control. And
yeah, I mean, that's awesome.
Man. Team does.
Team does, buddy. We'll get a couple pictures on, put them on Facebook, Instagram, Barn Hill Outdoors. But, man, dude, this is awesome. This feels good.
That's a heck of an opening day right there.
I know. It feels good. It feels like hopefully it's going to be a good season. We got a lot of hunting left to do. So.
Yeah, we got a lot of work to do now.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Two deer.
We got toe straps.
Do we have a big enough cooler for two deer?
I don't know. Honestly, what we're probably going to have to do is maybe rock and stop by Martinsburg or something and just, like, I'll cut mine open, fill it with ice. And
yeah. We'll figure it out.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. But, guys, thanks for tuning in. It was a fun day. And, yeah, let's get to work.
All right, so we got out of the tree finally. And we've got two deer to find. So we're going to try to look for mine first. We got some time left, but it's going to get dark on us before we know it. So we're going to try to get in here and see if we can find our arrows. And I know mine's down over there, but it's in there a ways. And his, we didn't see go down. So we may end up going for his first, actually. But let's get in here and see if we can find some blood.
All right, so found first blood. It's not like I want it to be. I thought it would be a little bit better. But obviously, I think she ran kind of up this way. So I'm hoping we're going to take her a little easy walking through here to see. But hopefully, we can find some more.
Right here.
Around there on that tree there.
There's some right there on that leaf.
And she's running through. This way here.
There's
something up there on that. Looks like it's picked up stuff here. She cut in that way.
Oh, here's some right here, Sam.
A little bit there?
Yeah.
That's what I think it's just.
Here it is. Here we go.
It's barely coming as it comes out that side there now. Okay. There's some right there. Right there.
So she went this way.
She went in the woods.
Okay. Let's see if we can find her.
All right, so about, what was it? Let's see, hold on, what time is it now? About an hour ago is when I shot that doe on camera and really excited. And I guess I kind of did the whole number one rule of getting excited too quick and just being, you know, happy and everything. And it is September 15th, it's opening day. So what do you know? But looked at the footage after we got down, couldn't find the arrow. So, got down, found the first blood. There was a little bit of bubbles in it, but nothing too crazy. Determined, looked back at the footage, determined that she wheeled a little bit around as I shot. She might have jumped the string a little bit. And so not a pass through, but like I said, we tracked a little bit to where we got just down to little drops of blood. But yeah, it's a learning experience. Definitely got really excited. Corey and I both did. And definitely gonna just kind of back out, try and look again tomorrow, see if we can find anything or pick up anything else. I don't know if we bumped her or not. I don't think we did. I think we waited a pretty good amount of time. But yeah, it's just a part of hunting. You live and learn, like I said. I mean, definitely emotions were highest opening day. I mean, two does back to back. I mean, that's a great story. But definitely got to keep your composure, keep your, you know, don't jump up too quick. Definitely look at the photos, look at the video before you go out and actually get out of the stand. You know, because maybe with us mumbling and fumbling around, something could have happened. So, again, like I said, it's a shame, but I think I'm going to come back tomorrow and pick up where I left off.
All right, so we're going to go back to my deer. I did see it go down, but let's try to get the blood and try to follow up pretty quick. Now we are kind of racing his time because it is hot. So we're going to try to get in there pretty quick and drag this thing out, get it field dressed, get some ice on it ASAP. So, well, let's go. There's blood right here. So she was somewhere right in here when I shot her. Let's see if I can find a glowing blue. Blood here, there, there. Tons of blood. Nope. There she is right there. There she is right there, man.
Woo! That's awesome, dude. Good shot.
Thank you.
Golly.
Yep, she is down right there.
Down for the count. Look at that.
Look at that, right there. Hard shot.
What a shot, dude. 35 yards, man.
Yeah. Yeah, she's a pretty far.
Yeah, look at that right there.
Good size doe, not huge, but good mature doe, and
yeah,
that's what I was looking for. That's what I was looking for today. Just want to kill a doe, so we got it.
Got her done.
So like Sam said, he's gonna come back out tomorrow. I'm gonna see if I can help him look for his again. I'm not sure how we'll do, but give it a try. But for now, we got, man, I think I'll start thinking. For now, we gotta get this thing out of here and get some ice on it ASAP if possible.